Natural history museums everywhere line up ape-to-human icons that supposedly show humans evolving from ape-like creatures over millions of years. After the icon named Lucy, which evolutionists place in the 3 to 4 million years ago time slot, the next ape-to-human icon is Homo habilis. This creature fits into evolution's timeline about 1.4 to 2.4 million years ago, taking the slot right before Homo erectus appears on the scene. Before looking at this icon, let's consider something very interesting about this stage in evolution's timeline. According to the current theory of human evolution, the time slot between 2 and 3 million years ago has almost no fossil evidence to support it. This National Geographic article puts it this way: fossils attributed to Homo in the period 2 to 3 million years ago are exceedingly rare. They quote Dr. Kimball, director of the Institute of Human Origins at Arizona State University, who said, "You could put them all into a small shoebox and still have room for a good pair of shoes. It's hard to imagine evolution pressing ahead for 1 million years with only a shoebox of bones to show for it. That's a long time to go without any supposed transitions between apes to humans." Let's consider the extent of the fossil evidence that exists for human evolution. Charles Darwin postured that if evolution was true, innumerable transitional forms must have existed. He also questioned, why do we not find them embedded in countless numbers in the crust of the Earth? We agree. If human evolution was true, wouldn't we expect the ground to be filled with numerous transitions between ape-like creatures? We agree with Darwin that the lack of transitions is the most obvious and serious objection which can be urged against the theory of evolution. Even Ian Tattersall, emeritus curator with the American Museum of Natural History, noted that you could fit all the supposed ape-to-human fossil evidence into the back of a pickup truck if you didn't mind how much you jumbled everything up. With centuries of recorded history and over 7 billion interfertile humans on the planet today, we should certainly have more than a truck bed of fossil evidence if evolution was true. Inventing a new icon, Homo habilis, hasn't helped with the scarcity problem at all. In fact, did you know that they've never even discovered a Homo habilis skeleton? This species was invented to categorize bone pieces, which total less than 100, into an ape-to-human transitional form they believe was becoming more handy with stone tools, hence the name Handyman. While they've never found anything even close to a complete Homo habilis creature, that hasn't stopped them from displaying complete human-looking versions of it in museums and textbooks everywhere. In fact, the best set of bones they have for this icon, which they refer to as the official type specimen, consists of just a jawbone with 13 teeth, a molar, a couple of skull fragments, and finger, hand, and wrist bones. The bones from this best type set of Homo habilis were found spread out over a 1,300 square foot area and were mixed with cow, pig, horse, tortoise, catfish, and bird bones that were also widely scattered over this entire area. After further study, however, evolutionists found that this defining specimen turned out to be a mixture of bones from different animals, with 6 of the 21 finger bones belonging to a different creature, 1 of the finger bones mistaken for a vertebral fragment, and 2 others belonging to a monkey. While the limited fossils belonging to this new Homo habilis icon were found with stone tools, evolutionists cannot be certain whether the stones were used by Homo habilis or used on Homo habilis by humans. They were in fact found broken apart and scattered over a 1,300 square foot area, just like all the other butchered animal bones in the region. Sure seems like humans were eating these creatures, along with a lot of other types of animals. Think about the tools they found for a moment. The tools they discovered included choppers, polyhedrons, discoids, and many small tools like scrapers. The problem for evolutionists is that most of these tools were made from rocks that were quarried miles away from where they were used to butcher the dozens of animals found at the site, where thousands of animal bones were found pulled apart and unattached. Whoever used these tools knew what they were doing, because they were all hand-sized, and most of them were made from a certain type of rock called quartzite, which can be flaked to a razor-like edge. Your average person today would have a really hard time making these tools. After identifying the right kind of rock, the rock has to be shaped using percussion and pressure tools, like pointed hammer stones and cylindrical hammers, like long bones. Plus, you've got to know how to make different types of tools for the various steps of removing food sources from animals, like meat and bone marrow. But the clues don't end with stone tools. The evidence that humans were actually the inhabitants of this site is also confirmed by a 12-foot circular foundation made of lava stones for a hut shelter they found in the same archaeological bed where Homo habilis bones were found. Paleo experts even describe this circular stone foundation as having a striking similarity to the dome-shaped hut shelters still made today by nomadic people in the same area. But it gets even better. They actually found the stone circle in a layer beneath Homo habilis bones. Now, that's not faring well for the theory of evolution, because whoever was there working with tools and building huts was on the scene before Homo habilis even showed up in the fossil record. This is exactly the opposite of what we would expect if evolution was true. The 348 animal bones they found scattered around the hut included species from the croc, cow, hippo, elephant, horse, tortoise, giraffe, and pig families. And do you know how many they found inside the stone hut circle? Only 11 small fragments, which were mostly toes and teeth. Seems like the leftover pork chops were being thrown outside the living area. The other clue that this site was being inhabited by humans is that 48 of the 50 pieces of debitage, which are the leftover pieces of rock that get removed when stone tools are made, were found outside the stone hut foundation. Sounds like a human living area to me. According to Mary Leakey, the lead paleo expert over the site, the main evidence that the stone hut foundation was an artificial structure, like man-made, were the six mounds of heaped rocks around the circle that were evidently used for support poles. She also remarked about the disproportionate number of bones and tools they found outside the hut and not inside, along with a 2-foot buffer zone around the circle that was mostly clear of tools and bones. The other amazing insight offered by the Leakeys, the very scientists who discovered Homo habilis, is that they found fossil evidence leading them to believe that Australopithecus, Homo habilis, and Homo erectus all lived at the same time. So, how is one species supposed to evolve into another over millions of years if the fossil evidence points to them living at the same time? Their position has perplexed many other evolutionary scientists, but they reported what they found. All three species discovered living at the same time. Now, all this data about Homo habilis isn't holding up the theory of evolution very well. First, we have the issue of the really, really limited data, with fewer than 100 bone pieces ever found. Then we have the obvious signs of human nomadic tribes living in the area who were setting up camp, living in huts, making specialized hand tools, using special rocks found miles away, and butchering and eating animals, including apes, just like people have been doing for thousands of years. Looking for answers about what the Bible teaches about creation, the fossil record, dinosaurs? Download the Genesis Apologetics app from the iTunes or Google Play stores for answers to these questions and more.